I think by far, fall is my favorite season, as I love watching the leaves change, football returns, and temperatures cool, or at least they're supposed to cool. Over the past 2 weeks, it has been on the warm trend. The only exception, 3 days, Sunday, Monday, and Tuesday of this week, below normal, but the past couple of days have been actually above. Our Rocky Rickia Max Storm Tracker showing that cloud cover from Helene, or the remnants of Helene, now a tropical storm. And temperature-wise, sitting comfortably at 73 in Rockford, 73 up in Janesville. Dew points sitting in the upper 40s, lower 50s here for us. And winds have been on the strong side, as, of course, we're seeing a lot of pressure change over the Midwest. Winds are anywhere between 10, even up to 20 miles per hour, and that strength will continue on throughout the evening and overnight hours. We'll see wind gusts near 25, even up to 30 miles per hour as we get into 7, 8, 9 o'clock. So if you're heading out to any high school football, you'll probably want a windbreaker, or maybe even a light jacket. Temperature-wise, though, not looking too bad over the next few hours. Again, 70 degrees at 7 o'clock, 66 at 9, 10, 11, and even at that midnight hour. But as we head overnight, that cloud cover will help us stay a bit on the warmer side, getting down to only 61 degrees. Wind still on the strong side out of the northeast, 10 to 20 miles per hour. As we progress on into the weekend, I do have some hope that we'll squeak out a bit more sunshine than what we saw over the past day. Excuse me. The question is where is the center low pressure of Helene and the low pressure system that we had across the Midwest going to end up as it's moving off toward the east? We may see a little bit of cloud cover here depending on, as there will be a very sharp gradient toward the southeast. That will be a lot cloudier, but to the northwest, we'll see a lot more sunshine and maybe see a sprinkle with that cloud cover as well. But I think most of us will stay on the drier side. As we progress on into Sunday, kind of the same case. I think most of us should be on the sunny side, but partly cloudy skies are expected with a few clouds here and there. And again, into Sunday, still can't rule out maybe a stray shower here or there with that cloud cover. As you progress on through into the beginning of the week, no rain is expected, even though Monday night into Tuesday, there is a cold front making its way through. And while we may not see it with our rain chances, we will see it when it comes to our dew points, as they will go from a little bit sticky just near that 60 to 65 degree mark, dropping down to the lower 40s, even upper 30s. So Tuesday is going to be a bit on the fall side, as we'll get up to a high of 69 degrees, see a slight warm up as we head into Wednesday and Thursday and Friday of next week. But as we get into the weekend, we are looking at near fall like temperatures, and I, for one, am very much looking forward to it, as we'll get up to, again, only 69 degrees for us here on our Tuesday, high of 80 on Monday, 70 then for us Wednesday, ample amounts of sunshine expected, and Thursday, Friday, back up into the mid 70s with next weekend looking very fall-like. Not a bad time to maybe go out to the apple orchard or pumpkin patch. We'll take a live look outside our Benchmark Exterior Skycarb Cam. It's been fun to watch that Skycarb Cam improve over the past two or so hours, as it went from mostly cloudy, now even squeaking out a little bit of sunshine.
Yeah, we love to see that. I'm with you. I like the fall. I can't complain about warmth, but I'm excited for the fall temperatures. All right, thank you, DJ. Well, still ahead.